In this video, we're going to convert a stylized character from Reillusion's Character Creator 4 and then convert it to a MetaHuman in Unreal Engine 5.1 using the Mesh to MetaHuman workflow. This is a standard CC4 character which we'll now export to Blender. Go to the plugin menu, select Blender Pipeline, and click Export Character to Blender. A dialog pops up. Select Mesh Only and click below on Export Character. We create a folder and give the FBX file a name. We call him Tommy. In Blender, we clear the scene and click on the Character Creator iClone Pipeline plugin where we click Import Character. Select the FBX file we just exported from CC4. And there's Tommy, looking a little pale. Now we see him with some color in his cheeks. We use the Sculpt Draw tool in Blender to modify Tommy's face. We're accentuating some of his features. By only moving points around and not changing the mesh topology, we can customize CC4 characters without breaking them. Now that Tommy is unique, we go back to the Character Creator iClone Pipeline plugin where we click Export to CC3 or 4. We select Include Textures and Face Smoothing, give the FBX file a name, and click Export. We launch Character Creator, go to the plugin menu, select Blender Pipeline, and click on Import Character from Blender. Select the FBX file we just exported from Blender. On the pop-up, click Import Character. Technically, we don't need to come back to CC4. We could have just gone from Blender to Unreal Engine, even without body or textures. However, for this video, we're doing this to have the original stylized Tommy to compare to MetaHuman Tommy. This step is also super useful if you want to continue character animation work in CC4 and iClone. Let's take Tommy to UE5. Select the character. Then click the FBX icon on the tool shelf, then click Selected. FBX Export Options pop up. Under Target Tool Preset, select Unreal. Under FBX Options, select Mesh. Then click Export. Create a destination folder, type a FBX file name, and click Save. We launch Unreal Engine 5.1, where we've created a content folder named Tommy. Just above the content folders, click the Import button. Select the FBX file exported from CC4. A pop-up called Character Creator and iClone Auto Setup Import Options appears. We select the HQ shader and click OK. The Unreal Engine FBX Import Option pop-up appears. Leave the default settings and click Import. The stylized character appears and we place Tommy in the UE world. Now we create a subfolder for our Mesh to MetaHuman assets. Double-click the folder, then right-click and select MetaHuman and MetaHuman Identity. We name the new file Tommy. Double-click on the new identity icon and dock the new empty MetaHuman editor window where we'll soon be setting up our Mesh to MetaHuman. Click on the Components from Mesh button and select the Tommy Skeletal Mesh. Stylized Tommy is now inside our MetaHuman editor. A tip we picked up is to change the viewport field of view from 45 to 20. Then zoom and pan to position the character's head large and center in view. Now click the Promote Frame button up top. Then rotate the view to show the character's right side. Again, click on the Promote Frame button. Rotate around to the other side and click the Promote Frame button for the third time. Now click the tab beneath the viewport to select the front view. Then click the Track Active Frame button above the viewport. This will automatically draw in some guidelines. Now zoom and pan to tweak the guides by dragging the points around to best match the character's facial features. In the guide list to the right of the screen, we make the two brows visible and active, then move and tweak the lines. We likewise also activate any other guidelines we want to include in the Mesh to MetaHuman processing. You can also switch to unlit render mode in the viewport to make some things more visible. Click the tabs below to switch to the side views and edit relevant guides there. For convenience, you can also rename the frame tabs front, left, and right. Keep going until you feel you've properly placed and edited the guidelines. Then click the MetaHuman Identity Solve button above the viewport. This generates the MetaHuman. Click the AB buttons to switch between Stylized Tommy and MetaHuman Tommy. At this point, you should review and fix some issues. But we'll just accept this solve. Next, we click the Mesh to MetaHuman button above the viewport. An error appears, telling us we need to first select a body type, and select Body in the navigator on the left. Select a body icon, and also adjust your character's height using the slider. Click the Mesh to MetaHuman button again. While that's happening, open the UE5 content drawer, click Add, and then Add Quixel Content. This opens Quixel Bridge. From the left menu, select MetaHumans, and then My MetaHumans. Tommy's default icon will appear. Click on it, and then click the blue Start MHC button over on the right of the screen. This will launch MetaHuman Creator in a web browser window. Tommy is alive! Although untextured and a little off-color, we can also appreciate that he now has eyes. We can now make some final tweaks to our unique character, making Tommy even more handsome. Once you're done editing, navigate back to My MetaHumans. This brings up your collection and we see Tommy's face appear. Click the green download circle below. A check mark appears to confirm the download. Then click the blue plus circle to add MetaHuman Tommy to our UE5 scene where Stylized Tommy has been waiting in the morning sun. Click drag the blueprint from the folder into the scene. MetaHuman Tommy makes his appearance, sporting a slightly higher body fat percentage than his stylized counterpart. Let's compare the two side by side. These two are close, like twins. Now let's see how well Mesh to MetaHuman managed to reproduce Tommy. That's amazing! Although it's obviously a different look, the facial features seem pretty much on point. Thanks for watching.